Hello everybody, this is Tekka. In this video, we have a super exciting topic for you today, and that is going to be Secure File Transfer Protocol. And what we're going to be doing is interacting with this through the terminal. There are some GUI clients that you could use, such as FileZilla, but one of the things that we're going to do a little bit later, and one of my use cases for this that saved me a load of time, was SSHing into one server and then using SFTP into another server to exchange a lot of files between two separate servers without any of the data or any of the files having to touch my local machine. So we're going to be getting into that in a little bit later, and we're going to be using Linode to go ahead and demonstrate some of these commands because this is my remote server that I'm using. If you use the link in the description, you can set up your own Linode with a $100 60-day credit. All of the packages include lots of cool things, including wonderful customer support, 99% uptime, one-click application, so you could go ahead and launch instances of Nextcloud game servers, things like that, super easy. And one of my personal favorite things is the user-friendly cloud manager, which you can see right here. This is my cloud manager. And what we're going to be doing is actually connecting to my techhut.tv Linode right here. You have the IP address, so after you go ahead and create your Linode or use one of the one-click installers, you just go ahead and copy this IP address, minimize this out, and now what we're going to do is go ahead and connect to it using SFTP. And to do this, it is really easy. All we need to do is type in SFTP, type in your username at that IP address. Now, since I do have a domain connected to this, I could technically do Brandon at techhut.tv, and it will work just fine, but we're going to go ahead and just do this. Now it's going to ask me for my password. If this is your first time connecting to something like this, it might ask you if it's secure. It's your own server, so you can go ahead and type in yes and you're good to go. So I'm going to type in my password real quick. There we go. And now we can see we are connected. Now, one command you're going to want to use is pwd. If you hit enter, you can see the contents or see what your current remote working directory is. Now, another important command is if you simply type in by and hit enter, it's going to go back to your local session. Now, one thing I want to do, I want to work in a folder I have here. That is my static.techhut.tv folder, which has some backups of some of the static files I need for techhut.tv. So what we're going to do now is go back into our SFTP instance now that we are in the directory I want to be moving files around from, hit enter, type in this password again, and now we are connected. Now I could type ls, it's not going to show anything because I don't have anything in this current directory, which again you could see by typing pwd. But one thing I'm going to do is go ahead and upload this logo png file into this directory right here, this remote working directory. So to do that, there are two commands that, well, there are two commands to upload and download. Downloading is get, as in you're getting the file from the remote server, and the upload command is put, as in we are going to be putting a file onto that remote server. So we could just type in put, and let's say we want this logo.png, hit enter. You can see I'm uploading to this directory. It gives us a status, super small file, it's already done. So now if I type ls, we can see that logo.png is now in that remote location. All right, so now what we're gonna do is go ahead and move over an entire folder with all the contents of and all the different directories. And to do this, we're gonna move over this img folder from our local machine to our server. And there's a lot of different things in there, and you'll see that when we execute the command. So the very first thing we're gonna want to do is make a directory. We're gonna call it the exact same thing, img. So now that we have that directory, let's go ahead and move some things over. So to do this, again, we're gonna do put, but this time we're gonna do dash r for recursive. So again, it grabs all those directories, all the files within all the directories for img. So once we go ahead and hit enter, it's going to go ahead and pull all of the different directories. You can see archive and all the different things, five things, Manjaro. These are a lot of the images for various tutorials I have on techhut.tv, top five Linux distros, battery life tips, things like that. But the point is it's easily moving everything over for me. And if you have multiple directories that are huge, you can open up more tabs in your terminal and just get everything up and running. So now that that is done, if I ls real quick and I cd into img, ls again, you're going to see all the contents of everything we just moved over. Now, let's say I wanted this BrandonHopkins.jpg uploaded into my local current working directory. Now, instead of using put, what we're going to do is get that file. So you just type in get for git. And then I'm going to go with the brandonhopkins.jpg, hit enter. And then you can see it fetched it from here and it downloaded it to my current working directory. So again, if I type in bye, I am now out of that SSH session. I could do ls, and now we can see it downloaded that JPEG into our local working directory. And again, we could go ahead and download entire directories to our local machine using the same exact method we used up here. But instead of using put, we would use git. Now, what if we want to do what I mentioned earlier and transfer servers from one to another instead of having to interact with our local system? When I did this, I was moving a couple terabytes worth of media files over from two local machines. So this can be with local machines, it can be remote machines, as long as you have that open SSH and FTP availability. So for example, let's go ahead and first SSH into a local machine. So I'm gonna do SSH and I'm gonna remote into my NAS. So let's go Brandon and then that IP address. There we go. So SSH into that local NAS, type in my password. I got a little warning for my NAS, but that's okay. We're gonna go ls, I'm gonna cd into my drive, ls from there. And you can see everything that is available. Now what I want to do is download the IMG directory that we just uploaded to our Linode server. So what I'm going to do from here, while I'm SSH'd into this NAS, I'm going to do SFTP, and then we'll do Brandon at techhut.tv, or I'm doing that instead of the IP address that we did earlier. Hit enter, and this is the first time I am connecting to this, so we're going to say yes. Type in that password. And now we're connected to techhut.tv from the NAS. So if I do ls, you can see we have the things that we're just interacting with. So I want to download this IMG directory to my local instance. So real quick, I'm just gonna say bye. Now that we're connected, I'm going to make the directory IMG on my NAS, hit enter. I'm gonna jump back into that FTP connection. There we go. And now simply put, we're going to do git. So we are getting from the server. I'm going to do dash r and IMG, hit enter. And now it's going to go ahead and retrieve all those files from my remote server and download them directly to my NAS without me having to, like I said, download them to my local machine and re-upload them. Just saves a whole step. So now that that's finished up, I could do bye. And then I'm in my SSH instance now, so I could do exit. And now I'm back on my local machine. And just to show you those moved over properly real quick, right here is my NAS. So I'm going to go ahead and connect to that. If we go into drive right here, we'll have the IMG directory with all of those contents. So as simple as that. Again, thank you to Linode for sponsoring this video. If you want to go ahead and play with Linux servers or do some serious hosting, anything you would need a Linux server for, Linode is a fantastic option. They are the largest independent cloud service provider out there, so they are not hosted or overseen by a big company like Microsoft, Amazon, anything like that. They're their own deal, and they are the real deal. All the commands and anything I mentioned in this video will be linked down below. Big thank you to our YouTube members and Patreon supporters. You guys are fantastic. And thank you to anybody who watches these videos and supports the channel. With all that said, I do hope you have an absolutely beautiful day and goodbye.